What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. More Eden today. 15 win streak. This is to tie my best win streak of all time. We have a decent damage stat. We have the flashlight, and we have, what is that? Something's only friend. Not Blue Baby's only. It's like my best friend or something. Spacebar item. To be real, I don't know what this item does. Sometimes you place it down, it turns into a bomb. Sometimes it does something else. I don't even know if I'm going to mess with it. Straight up. Like, I don't even know if I'm going to drop it once. I'd be, like, completely content with just, like, being rather be safe than sorry here. I've never seen this kind of layout for this boss fight. That was interesting. I felt like that could have went south pretty quickly, but it didn't. We are on the path here. Like I said, I might just avoid using the spacebar item completely because I feel like, I don't know if it's like a mom's toenail effect where the mom, you know, foot comes down and if there's, you know, no enemies in the room, it hurts you. That's as much as I'm not taking a chance. I think it could do that, so let's just stay away from it. And it doesn't really matter because we're going to replace it right away with deck of cards, which is much better in my opinion. We have a devil card now locked and loaded, ready to go for the boss fight, which is nice. And having a 4.5 damage stat right off the bat, and this badass mohawk is gonna do good things for us. We have a 1 speed stat, which is just okay. Okay, this guy is a little dicey though, considering he has this halo of fly dude just chilling around him. We seem to like not be able to really hit him. There we go. But yeah, this is to tie the biggest win streak ever. I think that first win streak, I think I did some random, some Eden, some Isaac. It was a potluck of characters. I was going to say, I don't think I'll hit this secret room, but we did. I'll drop some bombs here. Maybe get magic mush, mini mush, any of the above I'd be okay with. Even some pills we could take. This might be a net negative, though. It's not so far. Definitely not. 2 luck up pills. 1 courtesy of Verp. I'll take that all day. We did waste some bombs. Well, waste is not really the word to use there, considering we got 2 luck ups. More than okay with that. Oh, forgot to pop the devil card. It is just Little Horn. Shouldn't be too big of a deal. But I want to keep that card slot pretty empty because we have deck of cards. So I want some flexibility to use different cards or hold on to different cards. So when we get a chance to use them, a good enough chance, we should use them. Because you got to think of it like, you know, every 6 rooms we could run into another devil or an empress card. And it would have been a waste if we just leave one on the ground, you know? Pentagram's awesome. It's just going to help our already good damage stat. We're up to a 6.19 on the second floor. That's quite impressive. Not really impressive in the fact that like, wow, Jay, good job. I've done nothing, really. I just kind of have been a bystander on the run. Does this work? I'm going to say no. Oh, it did. I was thinking it would hit that bottom rock, but it hit like the side thing. I don't know. That was strange. It worked though. It worked indeed. All right, we're going to be able to pop this card after this room. Again, our damage stat is really good. We're pretty much clearing these on fire enemies pretty quickly. They're normally tanky. And we can actually do this, and I'm going to pop it right away because why not? I don't love my reflection, but we're going to take it. I think it ups your shot speed, so that's why I justified it. It's not my favorite, but it's not bad. As long as you have a decent range stat, you're going to be okay. We just got to avoid taking Epic Hack and stuff like that now. Okay, Ace of Hearts. All right. This is an interesting room here. Interesting mini boss with some minions that are champions that are no joke with this Brimstone. Maybe drop a health up if it's lard. I don't know if I'll take it because we're only at a 1 speed stat, but no need to debate it anyway. Not going to fight that just for the normal iron chest. Doesn't seem super worth it. This is good, though. Okay, we got a 2 of hearts, ace of hearts, ace of clubs. Honestly, turn them all into bombs, right? Not so bad. Not so bad at all. Okay, I knew he was going to blow up. I wanted to get that champion out of here first. The other champions we will now deal with. A little bit of crowd control. Nope, didn't explode into tears. Big room up there. I would like to check out the shop just so we can get maybe some more health, some more survivability, some more protection on this deal with the devil. We ran into the shop. Let's check it out. Black Candle is awesome. And I'm sorry again, Donation Machine, but this is just kind of how it's got to go. This is a run that's still very much in question. So to help us on the path to tying our biggest win streak ever, we're going to take something like Black Candle, even if we have to blow up our Donation Machine a little bit. But having no curses is awesome. The thing is, like, Curse of the Labyrinth is sometimes a good thing, right? Because you get two item rooms, two boss fights, you know, all in one swing. So it's not necessarily bad. But if you're trying to find the boss fight, like, say, like, a, you know, Womb XL could be bad because you take so long to find the boss fight. And it warrants, like, more damage taken type thing. So that's when it's bad. But inherently, I don't think a Curse of the Labyrinth is bad. I like it. It speeds up the run a little bit, and it gives you, you know, the two item rooms, two boss fights right off the bat. Now, Pageant Boy is not amazing, especially when you don't get any nickels or dimes in the payout. But Fear Shot is, like, good enough to take because it does up our damage a little bit more, and it pads it all the way up to almost 7.5 already on the freaking third floor, which is awesome. Our health is not great. It's definitely not great, but we have good room clearing, good DPS, so it shouldn't be too big of an issue. I don't usually take my reflection because the upside isn't that great of my reflection. I don't even know if there is an upside other than maybe the shot speed up. And sometimes, you know, you do catch an enemy like when your tier's coming back or something. So that is, I guess, you know, the upside of it. I'm trying to think of a good synergy with my reflection. Can't really think of one. That's going to be another luck up. Keep giving me the vert pill, dog. I'll take that all day. This should, like, warrant many consumables with this kind of luck stat or even some chests and stuff. Fear Shot was making him very difficult to hit. We did get out of jail free card, so we can get into, well, I kind of got excited for a second there because I thought, I was going to say, there might be a secret room here, so let's just try it. And there was a secret room here. I love Potato Peeler. I really do. That's quite difficult. I do like the deck of cards, but I might go Potato Peeler and then just go, like, Potato Peeler and then a Soul Heart or something? I don't know. Is it worth moving away from deck of cards this early? I think it might be. Okay, key and a coin. Money is good right now because I think I'm going to do that. I think I'm going to do Potato Peeler and then Soul Heart. Actually, now we have a ton of money after that chest. Jeez. That was like a Pageant Boy plus right there. Oh, but we do have a sticky nickel, which is fine. It's worth it right now. Yeah, man. I think I'm going to do it. And then, like, might as well check this out. It's not great. It's two of hearts. But deep pockets, sure, why not? Just stack it on, and we'll go. You know what? We'll go fight the boss. It's the Fallen. Hopefully get a deal with the devil item here. Two bombs. Two very well-placed bombs. Made very quick work of that. Well, this is kind of interesting. We have two items right here that are active items that get rid of red hearts. One gives you a Super Meat Boy, or a Cuba Meat that could turn into a Super Meat Boy, and the other gives you three Soul Hearts. But there's a big benefit in touching Guppy's Paw. Oh my god, let's go. There's a big benefit in touching Guppy's Paw that is, you know, it's one out of three items to turn into Guppy. So that's good that we at least touched it. But honestly, I would love, like, some sort of HP up in this item room. Because we could even double dip. Like, if we want to, you know, just get one level cube of meat and then Guppy's Paw the other heart or something. I don't know. Not gonna happen here. We're gonna get infestation, which is good, but an HP up I think right now would have been even better. I think this warrants checking out other rooms for the sheer fact of, like, we could run into an eternal heart and then use it on the next floor or something. You never know. You never know what you could find when you explore an Isaac, so let's just do our due diligence. Let's try to really win this run and tie our win streak because it's important, you know? We've come this far. We've come this freaking far. Did Black Feather just give me a damage up? Excuse me? I could have swore it's... Yeah, dude. I said almost 7.5 and now we're over 7.5. It definitely did. That's kind of weird. That's kind of weird. Okay. There's a bomb here. Secret room. Maybe up here. We'll check it out. Actually, yeah, that's the super secret room. So this should be the secret room. It is the secret room. Hit the button. And yeah, nothing good here. I'm not even going to stick around to fight that. Two of hearts not really doing anything for us right now. We could use a bomb to get that card, whatever that card is, but I kind of want to hold on to the bomb in case we run into a tinted rock, because we need some soul hearts. We need some soul hearts, man. All right. We're going to go with Cuba meat here. I think potato peeler, because I think the Cuba meat multiplications are better than just getting more soul hearts down the road. I mean, right now, the soul hearts feel sweeter, but I don't know. It's a long-term investment here, potato peeler. It looks like we have lard of some sort. What is making us look like that? And it's making me feel slower, even though we haven't gotten any slower. That was bad. That was bad, but quite a tricky room. It's not the worst. Okay, notched axe is not great. We'll just take a potato peeler. Yeah, that item room sucks. Hopefully we get something okay in the shop here that's worthwhile to, like, break the donation machine even more. But we need some help. We're definitely running into that area where we need some help. Okay. Chaos is definitely something we would probably break the donation machine for. I fucking just bought a key. Okay. All right. Let's just chill. Hate this room. It's quite difficult to maneuver. My reflection really came in the clutch there. Kind of cleaned up those two bombs pretty easily on the comeback. Don't call it a comeback. I've been here for years. All right, we're going to go down and then I guess explore some more before we go back into the shop, because I would rather not blow up our donation machine anymore. Okay, 3 cents out of that seems worth it. We do have to fight Peep here, which is okay. Not the end of the world. Just be careful of the creep. We just got to be careful of the damage we take from here on out, man. It's all very critical. Because our damage is just kind of stagnant right now. It is very high, don't get me wrong, but it hasn't really done much recently, except for that weird... the weird whatever we took that gave us like 0.2. Oh my god, you motherfuck. Okay, all right, we got little chub. Oh, this is bad. This is bad, friends. This is real bad. This is real bad. This one speed is trash. I gotta get like reacclimated for this like way less speedy run that we have here. I did this run like right back to back from the last episode you watched, and I think I was just like acclimated to that, you know, 1.6 speed where we could fly. Let's pull back on the reins here. We had some scares a couple episodes ago when we sat at one heart. I'm afraid to say it's kind of the same feeling right now. My reflection is just, why'd I take it? Why'd I take it? I felt like our damage was good enough that it wouldn't matter that much. And maybe that's still true. I just don't know. It's just the range is forcing us to get into an area where our one speed isn't really, like, able to bring us out of when it gets sticky. Alright. I mean, we're definitely exploring here and not really getting any tinted rocks or any help from the game. Okay, well, let's relax. Okay, that could have killed me. No big deal. Let's think. Secret room. Probably something we want to seek out. Fear shot, you know, doing its thing. Confusing the enemies probably as much as it's confusing me. Par for the course with Fear Shot. What was in the item room? Yeah. The item room was notched axe. What was in the shop? I forget. Oh, man. I was going to say, this has a really good chance of being a health up. Okay, it was... Okay. What we're going to do... is do that to start, right? Okay, that's good to know that there's one of the soul heart in there. And then we're just gonna go hard at chaos, I guess? I don't know. I don't really know what else to do, but sorry, donation machine. That is a reap. Okay. I don't know. We're gonna stick with this. What we got, at least we have another soul heart now. I'm glad I went back and checked the shop because that was getting dicey there. I should have went back and checked the shop earlier than when I did. And I'm sure a lot of you were like, dude, Jay, there's a fucking soul heart in there, mate. This room sucks with my reflection. Hopefully we get out alive. Okay, all right, that wasn't too bad. Very curious to see what this boss is about to drop. Okay, it's Gertie Jr. Try to kill the nubs. Son of a bitch. Not ideal to use bombs here. But I figure, let's try to get out of here alive. I know that we might see some tinted rocks and want those bombs. Okay, interesting. That's our second guppy item. Okay, these would kill us, straight up. Horror Babylon would kill us, even though, I mean, it would be great right now. It would be actually great. Do I take Guppy's Head over Potato Peeler? I think this is a yes. I know it's a shame that we didn't get to use Potato Peeler. I think it's a really good item, but I also think it's at the point where, one, health ups are going to be a little more rare than they normally are because of chaos. Two, our damage stat is 7.68. Therefore, Guppy's Head and the flies that come with it are going to be pretty punishing. Therefore, I think this is better for room clearing. This guy's a champion. But second guppy item's great, man. One guppy item away with chaos. And the shop right here, which is also awesome. What the hell is this? All right, that's the curse, or sorry, the, what is it? D1 or something? I don't really know what it does. I'll check it out though. It's the D1. Let me see here. I think I've looked this up before. All right, Rebirth Wiki D1. I don't think it's as interesting as it seems. That's what I remember when I read it. Duplicates one random pickup in the current room, including cards, runes, chests, and trinkets. Yeah. Yeah, no. I get there's a time and a place for it, but right now we need the damage of Guppy's Head. That was a strange room, by the way. That wasn't our shop. But we saw the D1. Okay. Gonna roll Guppy's Head for sure. Build up some flies here. This is not the run I think I would have been struggling at, but that's the beauty of Isaac, is it not? You get a good start and you're like, oh dude, this is a good damaging start. This is not a bad Eden start. Then all of a sudden you're on the edge of your seat. But that's, like I said, that's the beauty of Isaac right there. Never be too comfortable. All right, so we just got two bomb synergy items, which, you know, it's all right. It's a start. This is interesting. This is very interesting. Do we just buy this and then we do this? I mean, we could kind of go hard here and hope for a guppy item. And there it is. Oh, that would give me a red heart. I really hope to God we run into, you know, 10 more cents somewhere along the way. Somehow. We don't have a donation machine to blow up because we had the refresh, but I hope and pray that we run into 10 cents somehow. That sack probably would have helped out on that front. Okay, one monstro's dead, which is good. Cuts the room in half. Got some spiders for it. Yeah, it's real unfortunate that that sack is in the middle of that room. It's not looking good, boys. It's not looking good. If I was a secret room, where would I be? It can't be to the left or to the right there. What's over here? I see some money. Okay, this is interesting. So we can do this. Okay, that troll bomb was terrifying. So we got more bombs from that. And we got a cent. Got another cent. That's 8 cents. You know, we're closing the gap slowly but surely. I don't know about but surely. Dude, the tinted rocks. Where have they gone, money? Okay. I think that's if we get hit, we have a chance. Or no, yeah, I think so. It's terrible that I don't really know what Bloody Penny does after all these hours in this game. Another cent is something. Okay, so a chance to drop a half heart or a red heart when you get money. Now I remember. These guys feared are just so damn confusing. Alright, running out of rooms here. We still need 6 cents, which is not looking so good. I mean, there's 2 cents. That's going to bring us down to 4 cents, plus a half a soul heart makes it worthwhile. And then a golden key. Okay. 4 cents away from Guppy. 4 cents away from Guppy. No big deal. Oh, there it is, boys! There it is! And another soul heart, which is huge. Oh, baby. That just gave us Guppy and a red heart. Which is awesome. Unfortunately, we don't have the potato peeler to take advantage of the red heart. But maybe we're at the point in the run where it's like we're just happy to have some red heart health. Or just health in general, so... yeah, I'm very happy about this. This went really swimmingly. I'm very, very excited about the money. Allowing us to get Guppy, allowing us to fly, giving our maneuverability a boost, and again, a red heart on top of it. This is all good, dude. This is all good. It was definitely sketchy for a while there, and the two rerolls on the shop were clutch. All right. There it is, Guppy. Let's go, baby. I would love Littlehorn. You know, let's explore. You never know. We could run into another boatload of money randomly. Nope. Nothing doing there. Still haven't found the secret room, though. I don't really know. Maybe it's next to the item room? No, can't be. Interesting. We can't get the sack, though. A purthrow. Okay. Okay, interesting. Oh, he knocked into him. Wow, that killed him straight up. I think my flies are doing way more damage or way more DPS than I think. Pick this up for chance at bookworm. Check out the deal with the devil, which actually happened to have a Guppy item in it. I don't know if there's any point in me taking Guppy's hairball right now, so I'm gonna take sad bombs. Again, we get sad bombs. I don't know what the deal is with sad bombs. Hold on. Is this... let's just get it sorted. This is Libra. Okay. Basically, yes. Okay, this is exactly the item I thought it was. And as of right now, with 7 damage, I don't think I want Libra. We're gonna take it. Yeah, we just fucked our damage. Yeah, dude. Okay, I didn't want to take it, and then I was like, let's have some fun, and yeah, I regret it. I regret it wholeheartedly. But we are Guppy, so I figured I could be a little bit more aggressive and risky, I guess is the word. Not really aggressive, just risky. But it's okay. It's all right. At least we got more consumables, and at least now that if we get like a speed up or something, it's going to be sort of like an all stats up, if I'm not mistaken. I'm pretty sure that's how Libra works. I don't often take it. I know it's great when you have soy milk or something, or even like technology, I think, but it is what it is. I don't think it's going to end the run. We do have Guppy. We could fly. Everything is fine. Plus, you know, Chaos is going to do what it does. This was actually worth it. I did not think this was going to be worth it. But I also figured let's not be lazy about anything and do what we need to do to get as many advantages in this game as we can. And we're still doing really well damage-wise. I think a lot is accredited to our flies. But we still have a 4.7 damage stat, which isn't bad. I'm assuming Libra helped our tier rate, but maybe not. A little juke in there. Blacktooth, it looks dead. I forget what this does. I think it does add a little aura around us. I don't know if it like poisons or has a chance of poison. But I think it's better than Bloody Penny, especially because we have no red heart containers. So we'll take it. Some keys. Probably going to be the skeleton hands. So just be careful. It is indeed. It's good when you get the skeleton hands by the void, because their things kind of break right away. We'll check the double locked room, and I am gonna reroll this. We're gonna stay as Guppy. Yeah, let's reroll it. Okay, we have Epic Hack. Let's just be careful, but we're Guppy. Our fly should hit real hard. Our damage is, you know, up to a 45 courtesy of Epic Hack. We do have Bob's Brain, though, which we should be careful about. We are going to get a red heart because we got an eternal heart. But, yeah, this is, like, totally fine. It's always a little nerve-wracking to go into an Epic Hack run, but I guess the good news was that we already had My Reflection. So, we couldn't... I guess maybe we could have re-rolled into My Reflection or rolled into it, but... I don't think it was high probability. BFF is good. I mean, it's not as good as, like, you know, a hive mind would be right now. Mimic pills, interesting. Refresh is good. Let's buy this. Nothing really great. Plant seed's okay. Battery baby, not really doing anything for me. We'll just take blue map and we'll take more options. Car battery, we don't have Guppy's head anymore. It's not really worthwhile. I mean, definitely got some stuff done there for sure. Blue baby's only friend is huge because of BBF or BFF, BBF. Oh, you son of a bitch. I thought it was going to happen. I tried to tempt fate anyway. Well, that was quick. That was indeed quick. Okay, we had a 0% chance of going to deal with the devil, so I don't know. Sometimes the reroll messes up your precedent pretty badly. No big deal. No sweat off my back. Okay, I think down into the left-ish area is probably a better bet. I mean, Soul Heart's always welcome, even though we have 9 lives. Soul Heart's always welcome. I mean... You know, there's 2 of them. There's 3 of them now. I think it's like a... Almost like a lemon party thing. I mean, if so, it's better than 2 of hearts. 2 of hearts kind of useless. Tried to get the secret room. No, that didn't do it either. Bruh. There you go. There we go. A trinket we don't really need. I'm assuming it's down because the other secret room's there. It's usually a safe bet. Get him flies. Tier rate's pretty damn high too, which is good. And yes, indeed, it's right by... Oh! Right by the... I mean, it does go over rocks. I'm not a complete idiot. I know that Epic Hack does go over rocks. If you're just too close, you can handcuff yourself like we just did. But... as you saw when I broke the secret room door, it can go over rocks. It just, you gotta get the right spacing for it. Wow, that was really quick. Good old lump of coal. Why not? And then the bandage, I'm good. We don't really need health. We're at max HP. I'd rather soul hearts and black hearts instead of containers. Personally, that's just me. Small rock. Oh, another soul heart. All right, right and down maybe. This is a win though, by the way. This is definitely a win. Guppy, 45 damage, Epicac, you know, flies that knock as hard as these ones do. Verp. Health up. Something's wrong. I can see forever. Something's wrong. Okay. More money. Luck up. That's why you still pick up money, boys. I know it doesn't really matter, but that's one of the reasons you do it, for the luck ups. Which in turn are more consumables, which in turn can be more chests in the chest, which means more items, which means more fun synergies. And it all snowballs from there. Okay, so we've gone right. It's definitely not right. If it's wrong, I don't want to be right as well. Yeah, that was dumb. I mean, worth it, kind of. Okay, now we're getting a little rich on the black heart plays here. Ding, ding. Ding, ding. What? Oh, he's a champion that, like, deflects shots. I get it, you vape. Okay, just a troll bomb. We're gonna pass the super secret room. And the theory didn't work out this time, but that's alright. Wait a minute. Maybe the theory did work out. Let's just check right by the super secret room. You never know. Power pill. Power pill's probably better than something's wrong. God, I could see forever. We don't even have to bomb our way in here. And the theory did work out, actually. We'll take Succubus, because Succubus is awesome. Plus, we have BFF. This is a very, very strange deal with the devil. Never seen one like this, but I like it. Nothing wrong with some variation in your day. Tears down. Infested. Okay. All right, then. Let's go up here and then fight the boss, whatever it may be. Okay, it lives. For some reason, I don't remember doing the womb one. We don't really need the razor blade. Red hearts also don't matter, so I'll take one. And yeah, we'll be on our way up to the cathedral. Like I said, I think this is going to be a W. This is feeling good. It's feeling right. Wish we had some mapping, but having blue map is nice. The theory's worked out for us thus far. That's never a good sign, though. I guess more right than up. Yeah, probably gonna pass this first secret room. Feels like the way. I mean, we could, you know, bomb our way out of rooms because we have Epic Hack, but we're also, like, one-shotting rooms. There it is again. I'm an idiot. We got a soul heart back, golden key. Battery doesn't really do anything considering we have no space bar item. Okay. Yeah, buddy, it's gonna be right. It's gonna be right. Lump of coal is also good with Ipecac. You know, get that damage multiplier. Okay, it's not right. This is a room I bomb out of. Oh man, the theory still could be right. It's a lot of explosions. I think Succubus just killed him. Oh, I whiffed. How did I whiff? Okay, here we go. Small rock. Oh, you son of a bitch. I mean, health is still good. Theory's wrong. Feels bad, man. Feels bad, man. I mean, nah, we could play it, but it's really, there's no point in doing so. Hopefully down here. Down indeed. Yeah, I think succubus and flies are just kind of making quick work out of these rooms before I can even shoot. Landed with Bob's brain there, which is nice. Wow, died really quickly. All right, we have 26 keys, definitely enough to access each one of these chests, which is nice. All right, 10 more bombs, chocolate milk. No way in hell I'm taking Dark Bum. We'll take the 10 more bombs, we'll take the juicy sack, and yeah, let's get out of here. Chocolate milk epic hack? That's a yes from me, dog. That's a yes from me, dog. I don't think I want number one. I usually love number one, but we don't really need a tier rate. Honestly, a higher tier rate could be dangerous. So let's just stay away from that. I don't like the idea of going up there. Yeah, it's usually through the big room, as we always talk about, you know. That packs a punch there, dog. How did that... I'm sorry. What the hell? What? This damn greed. So many Steam sales, so little shops. All right, I'm still going with a theory that it's going to be by the super secret room, so that would be left. I mean, I'm sort of hitting them, but they're also just getting, you know, poisoned from the Ipecac, hit with the flies. I mean, we don't have a space bar item. The old mega fart. The old mega fart, boys. That was quick. Okay, that landed better. Bunch of red hearts. That idiot Dark Bum would probably like that room. I ain't got time for it. I ain't got time for it, Dark Bum. No one has time for you, dude. Alright? Just show yourself out, bro. Make them extra poisony. Made them extra sloppy for you. And rip blue baby. That is going to be a win. I guess we'll do the effing void, man. All right. I didn't do it last time. I don't want to do this on the streak normally. I really don't. I have no interest in it. It's not super fun for me to do the void. It's just okay. But this is, I guess, one of those runs where... I guess we can. We're insanely powerful, so why not? I'm curious to see how quick we could kill our boy Delirium. Haven't fought him in a while, to be honest. I would love to see Delirium right off the bat here. It's not. Well, this is gonna help our situation. Sorry, this people said, they're like, that shit hurts my eyes. You're not wrong. You're not wrong. It's a bit obtrusive. Okay, all right, we get it. We get it, Mama Mega. But yeah, that would be, if we ever start doing modded runs, if we ever hit, you know, 100,000% or whatever it is, if they ever give me the daily achievement, then we will definitely put in things like quality of life stuff, like Mama Mega doesn't do that white thing, because I could basically bet my house on it that already exists. Like, that mod already exists, somebody's done it. Which is much appreciated, you know? Like, quality of life stuff like that's gonna be awesome. Okay, alright. 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 I don't know if Mama Mega scales with damage, but if it does... I get why these things are dying, like, almost instantly. A one-up. I've been seeing one-up a lot recently. There was, like, a stretch there that I didn't see one-up for, like, a year. Legitimately. Hey, there's Small Rock. We kept asking for it. There it is. I'm not even doing anything. I just hurt myself. I just shot into the wall. A range up? We're already mom, so it's not adding anything to the mom transformation. It's a very quick void, though. I mean, I guess obviously so. Here we go. Here's our boy. Taking a shit ton of damage here. not ideal, but he's almost at like half health, which is pretty quick. Again, it's always underwhelming. I'm sorry, what the fuck is happening? But yeah, it's always underwhelming, the damage. It's always like, oh dude, like we have so much damage, we're gonna kill him so quick, and then you just don't. He doesn't scale, but 10,000 damage is just a shit ton. I'm a little nervous. Not gonna lie, you could tell the commentary kind of slipped away. No, we should be okay. It's just the fact that we don't have, like, the Polaroid taking over, it's like we could take so many hits in a row that it's kind of nerve-wracking, but we're gonna be just fine here, I think. There we go. All right, that's another win. Through the Void this time, killing Delirium. You will not catch me doing that fight a lot, except if we have a run like we just had, which was insanely powerful. Like I said, I just don't enjoy it that much as I enjoy doing, like, you know, Isaac chest type thing. But that is going to tie our best win streak ever right there. Eden only at that. I mean, the other one, I think I was slipping in some Isaac runs. So this one may be, I guess, arguably more impressive than the last win streak. But we tied it. We still need to get that one more win to set the new record, set the bar. Thank you guys so much for your support. If you haven't seen these two videos listed down below, they're probably average. If you want to see some mediocre gameplay, make sure you click those two videos listed down below, and make sure you subscribe for more daily Isaac content. Thank you guys so much for the support. Hit 250 likes on this. There's going to be another Isaac up on the channel for you tomorrow. Thank you guys, and yeah, until next time, stay safe, stay up, peace out.